Get to see Boro Fan TV. I'm outside the den. I have AJT with me. Yes. AJT, I was expecting the brant of rant. How are you feeling
that
now?
That was listen, mate. I was ready to rant.
Come
you know, I'm ready to rant.
Come on, AJT.
Do you know what it is?
We're going up.
As soon as I got to the 90th minute there, as soon as the free kick came in with the last minute to play, and he got cleared off for a throw-in, he had the whistle in his mouth, Kevin Friend. It takes for Salva's mouth, the ball goes in, forces George Trent, he puts it to the bottom corner, and it was limbs, mate. There was limbs everywhere that way in. I've never been in that sort of situation in my life, mate. It was mental, because you got to think about it. Until we scored the first one, after that first one went in there, we looked dead and buried, mate. We didn't look like we were going to come back into it. But beautiful George Trent, and I know I might have said things about him in the past, but that makes me, mate, when I'm out of here, I swear to you, do you know what I mean? What? It was just like, it was one of the things where we about to make all the substitutions he could. Fletcher comes on, Wing comes on, etc. Tavernier comes on, and them three lads there made a difference there. Brings them on, we change the formation, and bang, they go 2-2. And I said before the game, I'd be out with a point, but I didn't think, mate, Boro would get a point like that. I didn't think my heart would be going nuts down, mate. I need to go to the hospital or something. My heart's going mental, man.
Has that just papered over the cracks of the first 70 minutes? Or, like you say, was it Pulis's magic that got us back into it?
I think, you know what I mean? I think tactics substitution definitely made a difference, but, you know, you got to say, mate, after we scored the first one there, everyone had a little bit of belief, but I agree, the first 70 minutes, before we even scored a goal, we were rubbish.
Back four today was absolutely shocking. Yeah, that's my opinion, AJ.
Everyone was out of place. I thought Dale Fry was poor. I thought Ryan Shotton was all over the shop, mate. And then as soon as we get that goal, it's like everyone's just like believing in the team. You know, you can really see the buzz. And I think, you know what, today's almost like a stepping stone. Yeah, okay, we proved today that even when we're dead and buried, everyone thinks we're out of the game. But we know we're not. Do you know why? Do you know why Boro ran out of it all the time?
Come on!
We are the mighty punter, mate. Yeah, but never. You know what I mean? Boro never out of a game.
If you had Tony Pulis's wallet now with Steve Gibson's money in it,
yeah,
where would you go out and strengthen?
I think right back. I would have said left back, but I ain't saying left back no more because George, mate, you're an hero. I think right back definitely. Listen, Ryan Shotton could maybe be cover of a centre back, but he can't be our right back, mate. He gets caught out far too much. I think creatively wise, you've got to give the kids a chance. Do you know what I mean? It's all about the kids to me. You look at Fletcher when he came on, he was putting himself about. Tavernier was unbelievable. The same as Wing. Shame we couldn't see Chapman today, but you know, you never know, he might get a shot again. Strengthen the number 10 position. We definitely need the number 10 in there. I know we've got the likes of Johnny Howson, but is he really our number 10? Martin Braithwaite, he's more of a left mid. We most definitely need to maybe strengthen three or four positions, you would say. It's no good going out there and buying free agent goalkeepers. You know, Andy, I don't know you personally. You know, obviously, I should say, I've never seen him play a handful of games, but I wouldn't have gone out and got a goalkeeper, if I'm honest with you. But I think a right back, a number 10, maybe he's another right mid, because obviously, Shibby Downs out there today, but when he cut inside, looked special. When he's on that right wing position, he was getting no luck. And I think, you know, them little positions get tweaked up, them little positions get sorted, mate. Fair enough, but you know what I mean? And also today, Boro proved that we don't need Traore all the time. Because that performance today wasn't all about Traore, it wasn't all about getting over to the right wing. We brought on the kids, we made the difference, we made the changes, and look what happened. Everyone's going home with a smile. 5 minutes ago, I was coming out here to rant, mate, I tell you now I was.
Hey, JT. Cheers. Thanks for coming on Boro Fan TV. Brilliant.